how many of you really know about Shimaru, I would like to briefly introduce you to the company. So we are a 50 plus years old company, and I'm the next generation of the business family, which started, in fact, my father-in-law started the company. So let me take you through a little bit, won't bore you too much, but we'll take you through the journey a little bit. Okay, so I don't know how many of you are aware, but we've actually gone through a rebranding exercise during this year. So after almost 50 odd years, we've finally retired our Chinese lettering of Shimaru, which is what most people have grown up on, and given it its colorful avatar, as all of you can see. So as our current mission is to be an antidote to all the boredom and stress that people have in their life through Bollywood and through a lot of other genres of content delivered to them on demand and, you know, wherever they want it. So essentially, Shimaru has been, we started as a small circulating, book circulating library, which I don't know how many of you, most people in Mumbai who are into reading books would actually know about those humble beginnings. But we've grown, and we at least have become experts in identifying trends and curating content over the years. So we were the pioneers who brought in home video to India. We were partners with Sony Entertainment Channel, and again, we pioneered the satellite wave in India. These are all B2B businesses, which some of you may be aware or may not be aware, but we've always tried to bring entertainment and been connected with Bollywood, so to speak. So, as you can see, it's a 50-year journey, and we've been at the cutting edge, trying to get into digital space, and let me not bore you with this, but I think this is more relevant. So today we are the largest production house holding negative rights and everything to more than 3,500 plus films, ranging from the quintessential classic cinema to all the way to today's latest Bahubali, so to speak. And we are not just, another interesting part, we are not just in Bollywood. We also have other genres like kids. So one of our iconic properties is Baal Ganesh. And we are also into devotional and comedy and lot lifestyle and a lot of other genres as well. But almost, I would think, 80 or 85% of our content library is still essentially Bollywood. We are on traditional media, as you can see, so whether I think it's safe to say that most films that you see, whether on Star, Sony, Viacom, or any of the channels, I would think about 60% is supplied by Shimaru to them. So that's, you don't see Shimaru logo over there, but that's what our B2B business is. Home video, as Samirji said, is, we all wonder why it's still not dying completely. But as you can say, till the time there are players and video players and people around the world love movies, so they take the DVDs and they actually go. So that's the home video story. But it's been replaced by digital, essentially. So we are on internet, we are on mobile, on we are very soon going to launch our own OTT platform as well. But I think more about the OTT platform in some other seminar. So let me just say globally, we have a social media reach of active users, almost 15 plus, and we have almost 50 plus channels on YouTube. If you guys watch DTH, Tata Sky, I think we have close to 50 services currently on across Tata Sky, Dish TV, and Airtel, etc. Coming to the main topic, which is Bollywood. So internationally, I think the group over here sitting knows that licensing merchandising is driven by, 47% of it is driven by character and entertainment base. And Hollywood has made a really good example out of it. India's share currently is hardly 5 to 7%, or maybe even lower when we look at certain characters or, you know, And Bollywood is just born. As I was telling somebody outside, I think Bollywood related licensing merchandising is just born, not even a year back. So this is where Shimaru's new latest brand called Yedas has come into being. I will talk a little bit more about Yedas in a bit. Can we have the AV, please? Okay, while they try to figure that out, I would just say that Hollywood has done a fabulous job, whether it's Disney or your Star Wars or Star Trek or, you know, all the Marvel comic characters. Hollywood is way, way ahead in terms of licensing merchandising. And we all, at some stage or the other, have been a fan. Like, I'm a fan of Star Wars or, you know, Batman, Spider-Man. India, even though Bollywood is so pervasive into each and every, you know, part of our life, we've done a very poor job of it. In fact, I'm not ashamed, and I openly say this, that we have actually never tried. And there are a lot of reasons. India is a poor country, people don't have money to spend on this, etc., etc. But still, I would say no serious effort has ever been put. Most producers stop at promotional merchandise, and that's it. Till the time people get to the theaters, and then everything is forgotten about merchandising and licensing. Whereas I think there is great, great opportunity over here, and it has been fueled in recent years because of the internet explosion. I'll speak a little bit more after the AV on this topic.
Favorite entertainer, now in a new avatar.
I am a disco dancer.
Father ka bachcha abhi tak kyon nahi aaya?
Father ka bachcha nahi son. Father ko baap bolte hain.
Aur tumhara baap tumhare son.
यहाँ लिबास की कीमत है आदमी की नहीं, मुझे गिलास बड़ा दे, शराब कम कर दे।
पक्का इडियट दिखता है, इडियट।
नो कल नो बात। अरे बाबूजी ऐसी इंग्लिश आवे दैट आई कैन लीव अंग्रेज बिहाइंड।
क्योंकि इस बार इश्क सच्चा है। हमारा भी और उनका भी
अवेलेबल ओनली ऑन www.yedas.com.
थैंक यू. सो आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर अ लिटिल बिट टेकिंग क्यू फ्रॉम समीर जी, यू नो, टू टेल यू हाउ वी बीन फॉलोइंग दिस लाइसेंसिंग एंड मर्चेंडाइजिंग स्पेस सिंस द लास्ट 10 इयर्स एट शिमारू. And I've been looking at it very actively. And we never thought there came a time when you can actually do something more, especially with Bollywood. With kids, yes, with Bal Ganesh, we were doing certain amount of licensing and merchandising. But again, being a god character, you can't put them on tiffin boxes and water bottles. So we faced those kind of challenges. But when a couple of years back, we looked at it and we were like, let's try this. Because with Amazon and Flipkart and Snapdeal, everyone entering the market, it's easy. People are buying. People can actually go through products, even whether they come from B-town, C-towns, a remote village in south somewhere or north somewhere. But people had access. And we thought we should actually try giving the Hollywood story and try making it a Bollywood story as well. And we went around talking to all the brilliant brains, creative brains, and we said, guys, come on, we are very excited. Let's put designs out, Bollywood designs. We've got thousands of licensing, merchandising rights for films, and let's bada dhamaka karte hain. Let me get a little filmy over here just for entertainment. And lo and behold, we talked to 10 creative studios and told them, okay, guys, here are these 5 really good movies, cult films, and do something. Just wow us. And we are waiting patiently. And after about 4 months, the designs come to us. And we look at them and we shake our head. Oh my God, the only thing we saw was posters put on t-shirts, on mugs, and we are like, guys, this will not sell. I don't like it. Forget anyone else. How do you expect to go and sell this in the market? And they told us, you can't do anything with Bollywood. It's not possible. I said, how is that? I refuse to believe it, that you can't do anything with Bollywood, because whether you're old, whether you're 60-year-old, you're constantly singing songs. I think anyone who's into singing, you are mouthing 50s and 60s and Kishore and Lata and Rafi. You're actually saying dialogues without realizing they're actually from films. And the new generation also knows certain dialogues. They may not know which film it is from, but Bollywood is in every aspect of our life. So we were like, okay, we are not going to give up because we have a large repertoire and we think we can make a business case out of it. So we are essentially fully Bollywood mad people. We eat, breathe, live Bollywood, at Shimaru at least, because we are surrounded by so many films and, film talks, so to speak. And we said, okay, let's do one thing. My team, we sat down and we said, let's go crazy. How do you go crazy with Bollywood? So they started watching movies and they're like, I really think, I'm not ashamed to call myself a Bollywood fan. There are people who'll say, no, I'm just a Hollywood fan, I don't watch Hindi movies. And then of course you have movies which are crossing 300 crores, 400 crores, then they go and do Big Dhamaka in China. So this is Bollywood. Hollywood goes crazy about Bollywood. We, in India still, some of us say, no, very boring, very masala. But you know what, we thought, we are the fully masala, fully drama, fully Bollywood. Let's just no longer be ashamed about it. Because I think India is going places around the world. And I don't think there's anything to feel ashamed of, whether you're Indian or whether you like Bollywood. So with that attitude, we went and we started designing our products. And we were like, okay, if I'm disco, in India, disco is Mithun Chakravarty. I'm a disco dancer. You go to all the pubs on a Friday night, and after the good, I love Western music, so all those songs, finally, the real Indian comes out when they start playing Bollywood and everyone is like, forget it, and I'm there. And then you see what happens to everyone sitting in this room also. If Ruthika is going to start playing Bollywood music right now, after 2 drinks, it's Bollywood, which makes us feel Indian and alive. So with that attitude, we started actually tweaking, taking dialogues, and what you saw briefly at least was how you can take certain dialogues and put it on products and make it relevant to both generations, the older generation as well as the new. So when we first kind of did a market debut in Comic-Con, and we had a couple of t-shirts which said, Father ko baap bolte hai, tumhara baap tumhare saamne khada hai, and hum jahan khade hote hai, line wahi se shuru hoti hai. We had this interesting observation where a 16-year-old walks in with their parent who's in their late 40s and 50, and they're both laughing at it. Anyway, the partnership opportunities and you know that we are currently exploring is in these particular genres. So of course, licensing through characters or quirky dialogues, cult designs, and of course, making Bollywood-themed workspaces or restaurants. We are, you know, actually talking to people on those lines. So thank you very much for your time. And if you have any question, I'll be happy to take them.
You didn't talk about much on the in-film merchandising and the licensing of that. Have you ever tried it? Because I have done it. And I've done it with different firms. And with some, I was hugely successful. And with some, it was miserable. The three films that I did was Bajrangi Bhaijaan, The Pendant, which was hugely successful. So that was done by me. Then there was Taaveez in Rais with Shah Rukh. And we did one bracelet, again, with Shah Rukh in Dilwale. Both those films didn't do well. I mean, one of the big learnings for me was that the product that we're doing has to have a relevance to the film. Otherwise, it doesn't work at all. So like in Bajrangi, there was a relevance in the film. So that was a huge success. I mean, yes, Salman being what he is today. So that definitely contributed to it. But I think the pendant was a central character in the film. And that played a role. Have you ever tried anything, and do you have any kind of an experience which you would like to talk about?
Okay, so what you're talking about is recent films, and when you do an in-film merchandise, I think there are a lot of examples, like Krish, of course, it's in a slightly kiddie genre as well. However, what happens is Indians are not used to spending money on something that they own, you know. That feeling is just about starting. And I think it will start first with the cult, with the classics. And it will take time for something like this to grow. Like Bahubali, I'm hoping, you know, that will grow. To give you an example, in fact, Amar Akbar Anthony, who is Negative Rights with us, at the time of release, they had tried doing some merchandising. Okay, they did a set of three razors saying Amar Akbar Anthony. Okay, they tried, the producers have tried, but you know, the mindset of people is very different. It takes time to change people's mindset. So as Samirji said, or you know, as Shimaru, we have been doing, people are not used to going to theaters and watching animation films. So we know that the theatrical revenue generation possibility is very huge for a market like India, but somehow, Salman or Shah Rukh or an Akshay Kapoor or Rajnikant sir will take precedence over a kid's film coming in the market because of the way our spending, part of our, how we allocate our money to entertainment. So that prioritization is different for people. So it's not a habit as yet for them. So trying to do merchandise, promotional merchandise, it's only that much. People don't connect with the particular piece of merchandise. That's what, somewhere we are trying to create a connect with Bollywood and making them wear that attitude of theirs. So trying to do just little bit in film, if it's a hit, it might work, and then you'll have to really market it a lot still after being a hit. Otherwise, I mean, you have examples of Maine Pyar Kiya. It's a temporary fad, you know, with a friend cap and the, that's it. I mean, a few examples here and there you'll see, but you have to create a relationship of the people.
Do you think that Indian market is today ready? For example, what if I do Jai Veeru dolls? I mean, almost like a Barbie doll. Do you think that Indian audience is ready for this?
I think
kind of
now, because
today, because Sholay was maybe 30, yes, 40 years ago.
Yes, but we have to remember that we can't always keep making fun of our own characters or, you know, franchising. Of course, with great respect to all the people who tried with Sholay or for Andaz Apna Apna over the last couple of years, people have created that market. They are not official license holders, but they have created a market, and the youth today is much more open to the idea of owning something purely because, I mean, when we were growing up, for us, owning a poster of Madonna or Michael George was sufficient, or a tennis star was sufficient. But this generation, where they are used to IPL and, you know, owning, feeling that ownership with a team or a person or a character, I think the market is ready. It will take time, but you'll have to really develop it, and I think the market is ready. And if we don't start today, we can't compare to Disney and Hollywood. They've started about almost 100 years back. So if we need to reach there, we have to start somewhere. So today the market is ready and the means are ready. If somebody sitting in a BOC town wants something, they can actually browse. The mobile explosion in India and how fast we are, it's given everyone a shopping cart in their hand. So if you have the money, you will at least try it. Like I'll tell you right now, people are sampling, as we call it, with coasters, with, you know, keychains, with fridge magnets, because that MRP value is just right for them to own that and see whether acha ye feel hai. Then they will actually go show off to their friends and they realize that acha, you know, I have a talking point. That's how then they will start actually picking more stuff, and I think it's the right time to answer your question.
Ma'am, the dialogues which you guys have been using, they are very commonly used by everyone. How do you license them and how do you do them patent, or how do you go about this?
Right.
There are so many people using these same lines and making a lot of merchandise.
I don't think people are using the same lines, but if they are, then they are doing it without the license. But it's okay, we let them do it because they are trying to grow the market, you know, to that extent. The reason why we are making it a bit generic, okay, is because if I put a poster and I write this is from this film, the today's generation, there is no value to it. They will say, oh, ye kisi, you know, event mein, free mein diya hoga, isliye aapke paas hai. It's not an attitude. Even their friends will be like, acha, which event did you go? Who gave this to you? So the person will not feel ownership of that piece. Now, secondly, why we are going generic? A, Bollywood dialogues are generic. We use them in our everyday life. So it's kind of interchangeable. Like, did you say the dialogue first or did you see the dialogue in the movie and started using it in your everyday life? Third point, I think today's generation needs to identify. We have to help them realize the Bollywood fan in them. So if you go to sites like TikTok, Musical.ly, Vigo, and a lot of other video sites, you find, I don't know how many of you have actually seen any of these apps. Have you all seen? Very few people. My humble request, just download for one day and just see. You will be shocked of what, you know, we are not the target audience. The generation which is the target audience of buying our products is actually doing crazy stuff out there. So if you go to Vigo, TikTok, just see, there are people who are mujhe se kaam ki nahi, aaram ki zarurat hai. If I ask any of you, chances are you don't know from which film this dialogue is. Right, anyone? Okay, it's from Jab Jab Phool Khile. Half of you probably don't know which film this is. Shashi Kapoor film, very, very good, okay. However, ask a person, a 20-year-old, he knows the dialogue, he doesn't know which film. Because on Vigo and TikTok, I've seen people from, I'm sometimes amazed which village, which town, where are they sitting with the mobile and they are actually mouthing the dialogue and they are enacting it out without knowing. So if I then use mujhe kaam ke nahi, aaram ki zarurat hai, that same audience is going to pick up the t-shirt or mug or whatever else, basically. So to answer your question, we are trying to tweak certain dialogues and making it today, you know, to help identify the youth, to identify with it. Then eventually on our social media, we let them know it is from this film, by the way, in case if you all are wondering. So that's, it's a tough task, but that's the strategy we are using, because we notice if we give somebody a Sholay t-shirt, I'm telling you, the 20-25-year-old is least interested. In fact, the funny part is, a 16-year-old doesn't know today what Dilwale Dulhaniya Le Jayenge is. They don't. DDLJ is a cult film, right? For most of us, forget anything else. A 16-year-old, please go home and ask any 16-year-old. Chances are they don't know what DDLJ is. They don't know what Shah Rukh is doing like this, or why the train sequence is funny, you know? we know why it is funny and we laugh when a parody is made out of it. These kids don't know. They say, what is so funny about somebody trying to jump into a train? You know, it's illegal. That's what a 10-year-old told me. It's illegal. You know, they'll die if they fall. They don't find the humor in it. So you have to connect them to it.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you so much, all of you.
Well, I think that was a wonderful conversation, you know, and she rightly said that we have to kind of connect, you know, the Bollywood with the audience, and trust me, with the Musical.ly and all, even I at times watch on Instagram, and I think people from two-tier cities and old ladies and men and everyone is reciting those dialogues, so, you know, hats off. All right, I would like to invite on stage Ms. Rutika Malavia to kindly felicitate Ms. Smita Maru, the Senior Vice President of Animation Kids Digital Licensing and Merchandising Division of the company. Thank you so much, and thanks a lot. I'm very sure people enjoy the whole conversation out here.
I would actually just congratulate Rutika. I think she's really working hard on this, and she's supporting all the new ideas in our industry also. So I think, again, a huge round of applause to her as well, please.